Okay, hello everybody. Welcome to Trading the Markets Live Trading Room. It's the day before Thanksgiving in America, and I decided that we'd do the trading room now in anticipation of setups that may come on Friday. And remember that the markets on the CME will close early on Thanksgiving Day, and you're probably going to see very light volume. That's funny, I just mentioned what I'm looking for here. Okay, Matthias has said there's a potential trade on the US dollar Japanese yen as well. So let me explain this to you first. Okay, this is the trade. I took a trade earlier, okay, and I just want to show you that. And I'm in a short at the moment from the 34. I got filled on that. Okay, so I'm already short here on this contract. Buying Climax followed by no demand is confirmed. Okay, now I've already got profits, so I've moved my stop down. So that if I get stopped out, I still haven't lost any money for the day. Now, what I'm doing is going to explain to you this principle here. And I'm going to mark this in and show it to you so it's very clear to you. Now, we had a big downward movement, as we can see. Very big downward move. What you all notice about the volume on this bar compared to all these other bars behind it? Again, I'll be pedantic. What do you notice about the volume on that bar compared to all the other bars behind it? I know we've got some new people, so please do contribute to this, because these live trading sessions are designed to teach you as well as to make me some money to pay for my dinner and for my wife's expensive tastes. It's demand. Yeah, that's right, Dylan. There's demand coming in here. We can tell that because there's two principles at work on the two bars that I want to show you. The first principle is a down bar on massive volume, and a down bar is closed lower than the bar behind it, but it closed in the middle. And that is the key part of this. We want to see the market stop at a certain level. It's had a big downward move. This is exactly what we saw in the Swissie versus the pound. We had a short alert that went out, the market fell, and then buyers came in. And you can't ignore what the chart's telling you. This is why I keep reiterating this, that if we send an alert out and you've taken a short trade and you see buying coming in on different time frames, don't ignore the buying, okay? It's there. Remember, the market's dynamic. It's not going to always go in one direction. So here, we had a very clear sense of buying. And if you mark the top of the bar here, that's your trigger number. Okay, that's the trigger number. And a trigger number is simply that. It's saying to you, if the market changes behavior and tests that number, then it's time to look for longs. Here it is. Comes in, tests. Up we go. Secondary test. That's where I took my entry. No supply, because I was in a meeting all afternoon. Otherwise, I'd probably have gone long in here, but I'd been in a very important meeting. So I'd gone up here, and we can see they tested it. Successful. Market explodes to the upside. But now we've got a climactic bar, and it's on, and I keep stressing this, the similar volume to this bar, 7882. 7112. So we can see that someone bought, or a group bought or sold, and have left their footprints on the chart. Now, yet I will say I'm testing a new strategy that Tom and I have discussed based on these two principles here, Pat. So you are right. What you need really, and I urge this of all of you, is to wait for the mushroom to complete. It's not there yet, but I'm trying a strategy that gets me in slightly earlier with a tight stop, and I'm testing it. And again, if this works, and a lot of these alerts that I've been trading have come from Grigory's work, this particular one is based on a strategy that Tom was showing me. He said, Gav, you're missing the market tops and bottoms because you're waiting for the change in behavior. So be a little bit more aggressive with a tighter stop using less contracts and see what results you get. So far, it's extremely promising. That's all I can say. So far, it's extremely promising. Now, remember, when we see no demand, we look for confirmation, which is there. Now, I'm in at 34 where the no demand bar is. Okay. What we want to see now is the market break down and take out the 0620 level. If it does that, then this trade will run back down to the round number. But whatever, my main thing here is to get the stop to break even as quickly as I can. So I'm going to show, I'm going to keep this chart on and analyze each bar as it completes. And it's a 5-minute chart. Now, I went short, okay, on when the market had the buying climax here, okay, and you can see this trigger here. We had the up thrust, which was definitely both, all of these bars are weak, as you can see. All of these bars were weak bars, but I used the 1-minute chart to enter, and let me show you that. And you'll see over here, right here, was your confirm no demand bar. Okay, so there you've got your supply coming in, the no demand bar, and you've even now got in the background an up thrust. Now, looking at this now, we wait for the, well, it's not, now I was just about to say, we wait for the breakdown bar. there we go. Now we've got the breakdown bar. So we wait for this to get to 1.0624, which is 10 ticks into profit. And then I start to look to take some profit. Now it might test this bar and go straight back up again. So now I'm going to manage the trade through, but I'm playing with the market's money because I've already made money in the trade, the first trade that I made today. Okay. So now if you look at this chart, which is a small time frame, you can see the mushrooming starting to happen. Okay. This is a critical level here. Okay. And what we want to see, an ideal bar, would be a widespread down bar on an increase in volume and then low volume up bars. So I'm watching for every up bar to be on low volume now. That's all it is, just to manage through. Okay. Now, because the London session has closed and we're coming into to Thanksgiving Day, we might find the volume is a very, very low anyway. So they may have already positioned themselves short on this contract anyway. Okay. Is there any questions from the new people? Any questions so far? Okay. And can I just ask the audience here, as we have got a lot more people just signed in actually, which is good. Just type in yes or no. How many of you here are members of Darren and Abraham's trading room? Just yes or no. How many of you here are a member of Darren and Abraham's live trading room? Great, there's a lot of you. Could I just ask you to type in, how are you enjoying it? Okay, how are you enjoying it? Just give, just get some feedback, please, while we're waiting for this. Oh, great. That's wonderful to hear. Thank you, Marin. Thank you, Piotr. Okay, great feedback. Lovely feedback. Good. Okay. Good. Okay. I have to say, guys, I've had some of the best feedback ever, and we've had trading rooms for some time, but I've had the best feedback I've ever had in the 14 years I've been doing this about those two guys. Yeah, and they stay on point. Yeah, that's good. I know they're good presenters, so that's great. Okay, thanks for all of that, guys. Appreciate it. Yeah, okay, good. Now, let me be very clear on this trade that I'm in. It's got nothing to do with the trend. I'm not using the scanner to find the trade for this thing. This is a new strategy that I'm practicing, right, or trying. I'm a lot more conservative than Tom is. When I was with Tom last week, he was showing me his aggressive strategy, and I've adopted that aggressive strategy, and I haven't lost any money yet. So at the moment, It's going with what Tom defines as, it's regardless of trend. It doesn't rely on a trend. It looks at a sequence. It's ultra high volume, followed by low volume into the same price level, and then a gradual breakdown to the low of the supply bar. And see, this is what he then says to look out for. You've got to be careful of testing of these levels because it can go straight back up. So I'm just monitoring it and watching each bar. If that test fails, if the next bar is lower, we stay put. We don't move the stop. But if it starts to push higher, okay, which at the moment it's not, we stay with the position. Now, you can draw a very nice trend line on this from the top, which is what Tom was doing, and the bottom of the bar here, and it projects it out. And then here, to the left, if we put on our trigger, this is an area where I may take profit, but I'll watch the bar as it comes down to here. If it gets down here, this will be the area I will start to look for some profit. But I'm going to watch each bar and analyze it. And it's a 1 minute chart. And I don't ever really use 1 minute charts. But Grigory, I believe who's in the room here, has convinced me that small time frames can be very, very valuable once you're in a scalp type trade. And he is absolutely right, to be fair to him. He is absolutely right. And Tom said to me, Gav, the principles of VSA will work in any time frame and in any market. And he showed me this. And I have to admit, when you're in a position and you want to scalp, these small time frames do give you some very nice principles. You see here, there's a little bit of support coming in on this high volume. Okay, they've tested it and it's gone sideways. So I'm looking at what the market's telling me about itself here. If it's going to push lower, I want to see an increase in volume, confirming the weakness. So the bar is moving down on higher volume as it moves down, but not excessive. I don't want to see excessive volume as it moves down. Okay, nothing really you can do on these bars. They're just very narrow spreads. We haven't exceeded this bar at the moment, and we haven't got exceeded the top of that bar either. And the high is at 631. So it's not a lot of volume coming in at the moment. That's not surprising particularly because of where we're at in the trading week. It's the day before Thanksgiving, but it is tradable. Yeah, Jack. Tom does use more than one time frame. His favourite at the moment, well, his favourite has always seems to be a 20-minute chart. If you have been to Tom's, you'll see a lot of the time he'll use 20-minute charts as his main time frame. Yeah, if you could see trap up moves here, but I don't really want to. I don't want this market to go against me because I've already made money in it. So the principle here now is, As we've seen, you've seen the principles at work. We are moving lower slowly, and it's very slow. Usually after this, I'd expect it to move really rapidly. But I'm not surprised it's just going sideways at the moment. But you see, a lot of the time when I'm trading, I'm going to wait for these diamonds to all turn red before I take the trade. So I'm trading it down here. But this time I'm in up here. Okay, so this time I'm in higher, which means it enables me to protect the trade. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move the stop down to the top of the upthrust bar at around, well, actually, I'm okay at the moment. It's 35. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to reduce the risk. Okay, so I'm going to take the risk to 37, reduce the risk down only because I am aware of a potential upthrust here. Okay, and now I already know I'm in profit. I could take that profit and have a very nice session, okay, but I'm going to see if it's good. I'm going to let this run by monitoring the chart. If we break down through 25, then we'll have what we call a running trade, okay, and it's not really doing very much at the moment, but they're not strong bars on here. So what we've done is I've reduced the risk, I've got money in the bag, so I'm not concerned about losing any money today here. I wasn't trading this morning, no, and I was in a meeting with our investor, Neil, who some of you met earlier in the trading room. We've been he's invested a significant amount of money in our business, and I was with him today for a very important meeting. So I wasn't trading this morning, but I opened and started to trade about an hour and a half ago. Okay, and this is the only trade that I really saw that was worth taking at that time because of the high volume on the downside. So I was long the previous trade. You can see here I'm now short, but I was long previously. Okay, I'm just looking at some of these orders coming in, see if we get some decent order flow come in. And now I'm short, but I'm short at a much more aggressive level. No, so you're new to the room. No, this is the live. I don't trade on a simulator. Here, this is a live account. The only time we will trade a sim account, or I will, is when I'm testing Grigory's new alerts, and I've been doing that for the last couple of weeks. So I do have a demo account that I trade those on to find out, if they're working, and they're working very well. But I will be going back onto the live account with that next week, because I'm so convinced of the indicators. They're very, very good. But no, when I'm trading in this live trading room, which we've had now for 2 years, I tend to trade mainly the futures market. I do trade Forex as well, just so you know. And most of the time, I'm scalping in the room. I'm not trying to take swing trades or anything like that, which I think I need to explain more in the trade alerts. I think is when we're in the trading room here, we're trying to find short-term trades, ones that can make us 200 or 300 bucks on a small account. This is a fiver. This is a $5,000 account. Oh, hey Abraham, good to see you, buddy. Okay, you're short from the same level. Okay, that's interesting. Actually, if you guys have got your, is Darren in here with you? Because I didn't know if he was, but if he is, I'll make you both presenters. Oh, no, Darren isn't here, but you are, so I'll just make you an organizer. You can talk about your logic as well. Apparently, Abraham's in the room with me here. I didn't know that. Do you want to do a quick sound check, Abraham? And yeah, you can contribute by all means, because I'm losing my voice a little bit after all the talking I've done today.
Yeah, just plug the mic in.
Yeah, hello, buddy. Yeah, good to have you. Yeah, you can relieve me a little bit here. I'm losing my voice a bit. I've been in a long meeting. Yeah, by the way, Neil was very impressed with you guys today. Very impressed. Yeah, he sat and listened for a good 40 minutes. Very impressed.
Nice. I'm glad. Hopefully, he was able to pick up some tidbits.
Well, he's not.
Does Neil do any trading or investing on his own?
No, he's an investor, and he owns quite a lot of stocks, but he doesn't buy and sell. He's learning VSA to keep him out of trouble, basically. And the reason he's invested in us is one of his stocks got heavily manipulated, and we saved him. And it was quite an interesting one. And he decided to, as you know, to put quite a significant amount of money into a trade guider, and then also to seed the hedge fund, which he'll be the guy that funds the initial £1 million, I think it is, that's going to go in. So yeah, and he's a lovely guy, and he's actually connected. And how I met him was because he's the governor, the chairman of the board of governors at the school that my kids go to. Okay, so we're breaking down to the target here now. So let me just manage this through. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move the stop here to break even now. So that's me done. I'm not going to lose money here. Now, what we're going to do, just let this thing run to down to the red line at 24, which I'm pretty certain it was going to go to. And then we'll see what happens here, because sometimes they test this level and mark it straight back up to get rid of shorts. And other days, they really push it down lower and you can capture a very nice trade. But either way, the last 3 days of trading I've had a very successful week. So I'm very happy so far, considering it's only Wednesday. Every single day this week, I've had good trades.
It's been a pretty stellar week, and on the 5 minute, where we had a test on the last 5 minute bar and it's failing. So that's a nice, what do we have, about a minute and a half left?
I'm trying a bit of a different utility. I usually wait for the market to take this trigger out and then trade at the no demand entry. But Tom and I have been being much more aggressive, and it's been paying dividends. To be fair, it is working. There's no doubt about it. It's just being a little more aggressive. But the only thing I would stress is you must put your stop just above the ultra high volume bar. That's where the stop is, just above here. Only a few ticks above. Doesn't have to be. It's not a really big stop at all. In fact, my risk on this trade initially was about $80, I think, and now it's zero. I mean, it's no risk, apart from my commissions. But because I've already made a great trade earlier on the long trade, I don't know if you saw that, Abraham. I went long on the euro down here. I think it was just before you came, so it was here. There's your shakeout, yeah, which you can see there. Then it was tested over here, testing a rising market after a shakeout. It doesn't get better than that, does it?
That's a nice, very nice setup.
That's probably one that I need to take a screenshot of, actually. It's such a good setup, isn't it? There's your shakeout. There's your test in a rising market. There's your rally, and now suddenly we've got the opposite, the opposing principle. Okay, supply coming in, no demand, an upthrust. I mean, that's as good. I mean, you don't often see it as quite as perfect as that, but it is pretty good. I mean, it's pretty obvious. Yeah. What were you? What other things did you trade in the room today? Because there's some people in here, Abraham, who want more details about your room. Because it is probably the most successful. I mean, you know, we listening to you guys today, as people are pointing out to me, you're not only looking for trades, you're actually teaching them consistently as you go along. And I don't know if you saw the, if you can see the comments in here. I asked the comment or the question before you came in, I think, what do you think of the room? And, you know, great stuff. Excellent. Really good. Great. Love it. They are the best. Very good. Wonderful. One guy says, I sent an email to get more information on this. A couple of people said, I'm still on a 1 week trial. Today's Abraham's explanation of crude oil trade was great. They stay on point, which is extremely helpful. Great learning experience for me. Yeah, I mean, there's loads there. You can have a look for yourself, but very positive anyway. Very good.
I'm glad it's helping. Yeah, we covered weakness in gold, looking for shorts, took a short in gold, covered strength in the E-mini, took a long in the E-mini, still long the E-mini, still long short gold, short the euro, and short pound.
Good. Okay, so we've got this test. So I'm going to start protecting this because I think this might pop up. So we're going to, I'm not going to take any losses. I'm going to start putting some profit in the bag here. So I'm going to move down to 30 and then 29, in fact. So I'm going to lock some profit in because Tom and I have been testing this theory that they come down to that high volume bar, test it, and then often if it doesn't successfully test it, it will take off to the downside. But again, this is one of those trades where this area, look at the low volume here. See the response? They may well test it again. But the great news about this type of trade, if the next test fails, this is what happens. And this has happened several times while we've been trading. It takes off to the downside on an increase in volume. And suddenly that turns into $300. So that, I mean, I'll leave that in there. That's what has happened. I'd say 50% of the time, that's what tends to happen. And it is only 50. But I have seen several times they test that. Look at where the red line is that I've drawn, right? And look at where we've come down to. Now, is there any coinkydinks in the market? No, there's no coinkydinks or coincidences. That's exactly what they're doing. They're testing this low down here where the high volume markup started here and here. And now they're testing it and they're supporting it. They're testing it again. Another test. That's a test bar. Okay. But what I'd love to see is this test fail, because that just, I will add another contract and then another contract, because it will run back down to the round number. So that's the reason for the protection of the trade, though, is I can see that it's likely to pop up. And it happens, as I said, it's about 50% of the time. Jack, the sequences that I'm showing you right now will be part of the alert service. In fact, it's already... one of these sequences is already in the software. You've just got to activate it. But yes, it's in there. Okay. But these sequences are not reliant on trend at all. They're not looking at the trend. It would be very clear. They're not reliant on the trend. They're reliant on the principles, the key principles. Now that's an interesting bar. It's a level bar on an increase in volume, but it's flatlined for 5 minutes. You see here, see it's flatline. So this could go either way, but either way for me doesn't matter because I'm protected. And this is how I like to trade. I like to trade by getting the stop to break even, which I mentioned to you when we opened the room, moving down once the market moves in my favor. And again, if I've already got some of the market's money, okay, then I'm playing with the market's money. And again, with these type of trades, If I get stopped out, great. I've made another nice day's trading. This is a $5,000 account, so it's not a big account, you see. So it goes to show you can add quite significant amounts to your account if you know what you're looking for. Yeah, Pat's just saying he's seen a few of these type of things happening today. Yeah, they do. They've been there. This is very typical, though, of pre-Thanksgiving trading at the end of the session. The London session's closed, all right, And you do tend to get this type of trading, right? You either get nothing happen on the day before, or you get some trades. Today, I'm very pleased that we've opened the trading room and we've actually got some live trades running, because sometimes you could sit there and find nothing at all, but there was a long and a short in the euro in the same day on the 5-minute chart. And you can't argue with it. Even the 1-minute chart here shows it. There was a long trade, tested a rising market, and a short trade, a buying climax followed by no demand. If you just go and look at those two principles, that's what you're looking for, to go long and short. Okay, any questions? Any questions so far? I'm not going to look at any other charts at the moment, simply because I'm focusing on the trade that I'm in at the moment. Okay. But then I will look at gold, and we'll get Abraham to look at crude oil for us, if that's all right with you, Abraham, if you can do a crude oil analysis.
Sure. I'm not in any crude trades right now.
It doesn't matter if you're not in a trade. Dylan, I've already explained where the short was on crude on the on this chart, but I'll do it in a minute. Let me just follow it through at the moment, because I'm watching very closely the number of orders coming in up here on the trading dome. I will explain it, Dylan, so don't worry. I'll go back over it. All right, but and I'll explain the reason for it as well. Okay, but I'm looking to look at the 50s and the 100s to come in. At the 3s and the 1s, I'm not interested in. What I want to see is the big boys showing me their hand here, if they're still trading here. The reason there's no movement, if you, all you've got is the retail trader trading at the moment. And the, by the way, this trading ladder shows me that. You can see you've got the 1s, the 2s, the 1s. I'm trading one lot. That's all I'm trading. But I was right. That test down here, right? If I'd have stayed in, could easily have cost me profit. No point in doing that. I know, I've seen this happen so many times where they test that level. There's low volume on the test. It starts to rally. It's flatline now. It's trying to push up. So the idea is to take some profit. Bang. Bruno says, can I see the graph in MT4? Yes, we can in a minute. But I'm trading the futures contract of this using the scanner in Sierra charts. So I'm not trading the spot Forex at all. I'm not interested in the spot Forex at the moment. I'm trading the future. Okay, but I did see, you know, you will find that when you look at the futures and the Forex, they will go in, well, they have to go in the same direction because they're arbitraged. So we will go and look at the Forex and we'll do a complete review of the Forex using my Active Trades live account. We'll definitely do that. But let me be clear, Bruno. I did not take this in the Forex market. I've only traded it in futures today. Okay? I could have, but I just did. I've only been trading for just over an hour and 15 minutes. So, you know, that's, there you go. That's what I've made in an hour and 15 minutes of trading. And I was right. Look, they tested it and up it went to the top of that trend line. Okay, so the question was, where did we go short here? This is the 1-minute chart. I actually use the 5-minute chart as my main guide. But this is where I decided to take the trade. Okay, and you can see here, it closed at 0.0634. Okay, can you see that, everybody? Can everyone see what I'm pointing at here? So you can see why I took the trade. That's the most important thing. So here's your weakness. Here's the no demand bar that's confirmed, but I decided to go short right there. As it happened, it was confirmed by an up thrust at exactly the same level. Okay, so that's absolutely confirming the weakness. Okay, so I've got a confirmation of the weakness. So I'm short, I've got my stop up here. Market moves in my favor to my trigger number, which is where I expect to see support. Lo and behold, look what's happening. I would be now under pressure, so I've moved my stop in, but there is more weakness. We may get another short, don't know yet. Another climactic bar on the 1-minute chart. 5-minute chart. If we look at the 5-minute chart of the euro, okay, this has got lots of lines on this. Don't let this confuse you. This is where I went long earlier on. Sorry, not that one. It was this one here because I wasn't there then. This is where I went long, okay? So, yeah, actually it was. It was 2 hours. About 2 hours. That's right. I'm losing track of time. Hop us four, right? And you can see here five. Yeah, so about an hour. Okay. Took the trade and then decided to short on a confirmed no demand bar right the way down here to this apex, which is this almost at this low. And then they're just marking it back up again. And notice as well, the 50% retracement level. Okay, from the top today to the bottom, I marked a 50% retracement using Fibonacci. And the market moved through the Fibonacci number, closed almost on the Fibonacci number with the climactic bar, just a few ticks above it. Look, two ticks, and then changed behavior. It's all very logical. Yeah, Dave, I'll explain that to you, and I think that's quite important. Piotr says, Charles is saying, be interesting to see what happens to the euro. Volume has dried up. Perhaps the major traders have left for luck. I don't expect there to be many more trades at all in the market in the next hour or two. I don't see anything. I mean, this is the most obvious one I saw. I mean, we can look at what we'll do is we'll get Abraham to look at the crude oil chart and what trade he saw there earlier and possibly gold. But for the moment, we know the day before the holidays, you know, it can be very strange. But I did decide to do the trading room today rather than Friday, simply because there was volume that came in this morning. And it was very clear that there was some movement coming. So some movement coming. Yeah, let's do that. Marius, just bear with me a second. Let me, I'm just going to go back to this 1 minute chart because then, yeah, we may be able to get in another short here. Crikey, I'm going to have to be damn quick with this one. Okay, I am going to take another short trade here because it looks to me like they've just marked it up. Okay, now that was a surprise, that one. Cool. I was so busy chatting away that I missed the fact that you've got an up bar and a narrow spread, next bar down, and then you've clearly got on the 1 minute chart some no demand there. Now, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to stay on this chart for the moment because I just want to see what they're trying to do here. Okay, I just want to see what they're going to try and do. I'm going to have a very tight stop here, only about four or five ticks, not going to be big. But I might be right that this might break down. That's very, I mean, again, I will say this, I look at the trend line, I've connected the two trend channels, the top two, and projected it out. It's blown through it, come back into it, okay, but I'm not going to lose a lot of money on this. If this starts to go up above here, I'm just going to scratch that. But I think it's worth another go because we have got weakness up here. They're weak bars. Let's watch and see what this bar tells us. The reason it went up here was because of the test here, but I bet you they're going to test it again. I bet you they're going to come and bring this down and test it again. That's what I think they're going to do. You could even see. So I think one of our customers here, everyone said, we'd love to see a trap up move. You may have just got your wish. You may have just got your wish. Oh, my goodness me. Wouldn't that be strange? Oh dear, it's been a very lucky day today. I must admit, everything's going right. There's nothing gone wrong here. It's been a great day, but that just adds to it, doesn't it? Let me go back and look. Someone said, we'd love to see a trap up move here. Let me have a quick look. You remember who you were anyway, sorry, but you said, say, trap up move, yeah. Yeah, Mark, yeah. This could be really interesting right now. That could be really interesting because you have got here the weakness in the background. That's the key to this. Now, you know, when you see the trap up move here, you really want to see a breakdown fairly quickly on a trap up. Now, it's only a 1 minute chart. That would be much more powerful, I've got to be honest, if you saw that on the hourly or the 15 minute chart, much stronger. So, Abraham, what do you make of this one so far? It's quite interesting, isn't it?
Looks weak.
It
I'm
looks
still
weak.
still short.
I'll just watch it. It's unusual that, you know, I was just saying the volume was drying up over here. Look, you can see how important these lower levels are. Look at the volume on this down bar. They're not ready to take it lower. So they mark it up, trap up move. They're testing at the moment, but that's quite high volume on that test. What you want to see now is a break. You've got to, I mean, if that breakdown happens, and I say it's about 50% of the time they mark it down quickly, boom, you've got a great trade.
If we can break down that 21 level on the 5 minute, we should be off to the races.
Yeah, I know which one you're talking about. Yeah, we've got, well, it's down here, 2021 here. I mean, you can see what they're up to. I mean, the way Tom looks at it, it was we looked at the, you know, the weakness in the background, confirmed no down. We have four down bars, right? So that's fine. We're short. It goes up, rejects price at that level. See where we broke down here? They reject it. Okay, and now what I'm looking, what I'm will look for this 5 minute chart is to come down to this level here and then explode through it and follow this next trend line down. But I didn't expect we'd see this tonight. I knew we might see some movement, but this is really good learning. I mean, for people who are new to VSA, because I was showing Neil earlier, Abraham, about how weakness appears on up bars, and he's been reading lots of articles written by experts in stocks that when you see big increasing volume and the price goes up, everyone's buying, it's time to get in. Can you believe that?
Yes, I can believe it, but it's almost sad.
Well, it's why so many retail traders just don't make it. They're being fed a line that's, you know, if you see ultra high volume in a stock on an up bar, narrow spread, and you're told, oh, it's by your broker, it's gone up, it's time to buy, or you'll miss out, then really you've got no chance. You've got no chance of making it. Anyway, we'll watch this for the moment, because things are happening. You know, we've had two trades on this instrument. So it's just gone 1 o'clock in New York. It's midday Chicago time. So 12:15. This may be a bit slow for 45 minutes, but we'll see. But what I might do in a minute, when you're ready, Abraham, is just hand you the crude chart and you can have a look at that, and I'll just keep monitoring this. And you can talk a bit about your room. There's about seven or eight people in here, Abraham, that are interested in your room. So you might want to talk about it as well for next week as well. Because I'm assuming you're not going to trade tomorrow. Well, you're not opening the room tomorrow, I'm assuming.
Yeah, no, tomorrow's Thanksgiving.
Exactly.
And because of Thanksgiving, then we're taking Friday off. So we'll be back on Monday.
Yeah, okay. So there's some people. Let me hand the chart over to you. I'm just watching. I'm still short here. Let me just show you. I'm short from 26, so where we're at right now. I've got the trade in. I've got my stop at 37, but I'm going to move this right down. I'm not going to let that carry me. I don't want to really lose more than four ticks on this, so I can take away 250 if it moves against me. If it moves for me, another $100 on this trade would be a very nice day. That would add about 8% to the account. So I'll be very happy with that. It's a nice day's trading. All right, Abraham, I'll give you the chart.
Sounds good.
There you go.
My stop, I'm still short the euro. Stops at break-even plus one, just to cover commission, to see if we can catch a runner. Almost got stopped out on the pound, about a tick away, still short. Stops at break-even plus one. Short on gold here, you can see on the hard right edge, we just had a markup, which was rejected. Looks like we're doing a trap-up move on the 5 minute. We got about 30 seconds left, so if we start breaking down, I'll be moving my stop down accordingly. Crude oil, we had some really, really big volume coming in the morning. It looked like it was distributing. It was supply coming in right into the overnight session highs. Then we had the API report come out. This is the ultra-high volume bar that came out. I was really leery because of all the what appeared to be potential selling in the morning to take any longs. There was a test, and I covered it in the room. You have to obey the charts. You can't go based off of your gut feeling. So I, when my gut feeling and the charts are not in alignment, I just I didn't take this trade. But you can see it was a successful test. Never really took any heat off of this test, and we're off to the races. That move from this test, 42.34 to 79, you're talking about 45 ticks, so $450 overall on that long. Looking for the breakdown on the Euro 5 minute. This level, the same level you have, 0.621. And it's funny because we took the short at, I just got stopped out of the pound. We took the trade based off of the same no demand. I saw no demand here, confirmed on the next bar, took the short here. Stop was above the ultra high volume bar. As soon as we started breaking down, I moved my stop down to break even. So hopefully we can see further push down. I'm not going to lose money on the trade. It's only with one contract, so I'd like to see that big slice down. But pretty similar in the approach. Gold, we did have that trap up move with that markup in the background, so expecting at least to come down to these lows. If we start seeing volume increase, then just be trailing my stop down. That's all I got, really. Stops are on the short. Is right above these swing highs, 0.7230 plus two ticks, 0.7250. It's a two lot short, looking to take the first leg off in this area, 0.6970. And as soon as this one triggers, I'll be moving my stop down to break even on the second leg. No, Manish, the email alerts today were a bit slow, I think because of the holidays and just the sideways action on most of the markets. It's just been a slow alert day. But I can check to see if anything's come in the last 15, 20 minutes. You'll see the last alert that came in was 6:30 a.m. today. So pretty slow day on the alerts, pretty slow day overall. We just took that short in the Euro. It was a one lot trade because of the aggressiveness of it. We hadn't waited. We did not wait for the change in behavior. That's why it was a one lot trade on both the Euro and the pound. Same with the E-mini. It was a one lot long. I got stopped out at break even plus one tick. I was up about 9 or 10 ticks. I was looking to break out of this morning session high, and then we started failing. Started getting some no demand. And you really have, guys, you guys got to pay attention to the software. It's telling you there's no demand back into the previous markup where we saw potential strength. All of a sudden, volume dies off. We get a no demand. It's a confirmed no demand. And now we're starting to sell off. My stop was two ticks below this last test, and I got stopped out about 5 minutes ago. So heed the software. You know, I didn't take the long trade on crude oil here based off of this test. It was successful. I should have trailed my stop up a little bit. I was looking to see if I could catch a breakout, a nice little trade, and it pulled back. So heed it. Heed what the software's telling you. The software doesn't have any emotions. We do. That being said, of course, the euro is now flat. Let's see what the 1 minute saying on the euro. Got this last supply hitting. Potential buying climax. Next bar's down, confirms a weakness. Market up again, right into the close. Again, we see weakness. Now we're seeing an upthrust. So it looks like there's somebody or some group trying to support it down here at the 24.21, which is the bottom of that ultra high volume bar on the 5 minute. You can see here is where the last markup came in. See, there is some support here, but as soon as we start slicing through, we should see the market start to pick up steam on the downside, which would be nice. Cover it live. Hey, Any questions on crude oil or the euro or gold or the E-mini or the pound? Pound 1 minute. What I'm leery of, Peter, is when we've had a period of prices moving higher, we have a prior top to the left over here where we had a lot of volume come in, a lot of selling stepping in. The markup happened on this volume bar right at the bottom of this upthrust. So you got to be leery. There could be another upthrust. We have some high volume areas up here from yesterday, 51.48. So we could see an additional markup, but looks like they're starting to unload those positions. They're testing it, but remember, they can continue to mark it up and trap in traders. Peter, is your change in behavior what you're – are you looking at potentially shorting the pound? Is that what you mean? Because I misunderstood you. I thought you were talking about longs. Yeah, shorts. I'm pretty bearish on the pound. Been bearish for a while. Still in a pound short from a few days ago. Short from this area, 52.20. This is the 2 hour chart of the GBP USD. So short there, we just had some, looks like some more supply coming in. Oh, an upthrust. So just be leery. Just be aware that we have this markup in the back. We need to see some breakdown, which we are, and then see some no demands back into that same area. Some lack of interest. The euro is responding a little bit better. We're down below at 25. But really that 24, between that 24 and 21, 24 on the 1 minute chart and 21 on the 5 minute chart, those are pretty key areas. You can see here on the 1 minute chart, the low is 0624. That's what we're challenging right now. As per the volume, the way it's coming in, it looks like we should be breaking down. If we break that 24, the next one will be 21. And if we break the 21, then we should start seeing the market picking up some speed. Yeah, Peter, that's one of Tom's favorite setups, is the no demand followed by a test in a rising market. He's been trading that very successfully. Anybody in any trades, looking at anything, any questions I can answer while I'm on? We're starting to get there, Dylan. I know ideally you want to wait for the 5 minutes to roll over. That was why we took this as a one lot warrior trade. We had the ultra high volume bar on the 5 minute followed by a no demand. It lined up with the 1 minute. So we're looking for shorts, but we still haven't changed behavior yet. We're starting to. You can see the diamond trending system turning white. It's gone from green to white. And now we need to see that mark down, see the trending system turn red, and then look for no demands. That would be the safest, most conservative entry. But like Gavin mentioned, we a little aggressive on this trade. You can see they're marking it up again. They could mark it right back up into this upthrust. You see this upthrust back here, trap up move? Right into this area, 0631. Got to see how the next bar is going to react, because we just had supply hit the market. So if the next bar is down and we start breaking down, it should be a nice signal.
Yeah, that was one of the dangers, Abraham, that they're going to whip it around a little bit here. So if it goes up another tick or two, I'm not gonna let carry it. I'm just gonna scratch it and call it a day. But you know, it was worth it because it is trying to break that level.
It's trying. That's why I mean I'm giving it a little bit of room to try to work itself out. Like I got the stop down to break even plus one, so not gonna lose any money. And that's kind of rule number one that we keep hammering in on every day is protect your capital. If you keep losing, you're not gonna be able to recoup.
Yeah, that's me dumb.
We would have to see a clear move above that ultra-high volume bar back here. You'd want to see a clear push above on increasing volume and then testing right back into the top of this ultra-high volume on 0645 or of that ultra-high volume bar if you're looking to try to scalp this long. But right now, it's you know that's what you have to keep in mind. Look at the size of that one-minute volume bar. That's the highest going back 2 days. And it's the high is right into yesterday's high volume area as well. So they ram it up after moving it up from these lows. They ram it up. It's the largest print on the 1 minute bar going back, you know, almost a day and a half, 2 days. That's why it was an aggressive short for me. I was looking for any no demand really on the 1 minute. I got it right here, confirmed. So took it short. To change that perspective, we really would need to push through this. You got to understand there's a lot of volume sitting right here. From yesterday's session, from today, there's a lot of volume. So you got to kind of think of it as a ceiling. If you want to start going long, you have to break through that volume ceiling and then come back and test it. If you see that, possibly, but realize it's 10:30. 10:30 Pacific Standard Time, it's 1:30 Eastern Standard. So we have a whole 2.5 hours left. Not likely to happen. It could, but not likely. Gavin, I would assume so. I don't think they celebrate Thanksgiving in Europe. Are the European markets open tomorrow?
They are. Yeah, we don't celebrate Thanksgiving because I think what we're thanking is the fact that you kicked the Brits up the backside and kicked us out of your country, something like that. But I know that's Independence Day, close. But no, we don't do Thanksgiving. No.
So yeah, Dylan, they'll be open tomorrow.
Mind you, I have to celebrate Thanksgiving for a different reason.
Well, yeah.
Her name's Laura.
Totally understandable. Do you tell me you don't appreciate a nice home-cooked turkey meal?
We are going to Richard's on Sunday with Laura's friend who's over from Chicago, and we are having, of course, a turkey and celebrating Thanksgiving, and everything's completely different from the way the Brits do it. It's very American, and we've done that every year since we've been in England, so we haven't changed since I've been back. So for Excellent. Me, sort of for the kids, Christmas and the whole period, the whole holiday period, starts really from tomorrow, but Sunday is when we have the Thanksgiving dinner. Be nice, and we invite a load of English people round who've not experienced that before. So it's good. I like it. It's a good holiday.
I love it. It's probably my favorite holiday, just because I love to eat.
Well, yeah. See, but in England it's a complete opposite. Everyone eats at Christmas. You see, they don't on the 25th of December. You know, that's when they. So that's just a slightly different thing. But so it was great for me when I was in America. I had two large dinners here. Now this is at the moment this is quite interesting. This chart, looking at it here, is it's rejecting the 50% retracement at three. I'm still not stopped out. I've moved my stop down to 34, but it's rejecting the retracement level, which I've got on my screen. But anyway, I mean, we'll leave it on yours. It's fine. It's just rejected.
You got this markup followed by a note. All of a sudden, look at the volume on the next bar.
Yeah,
you start trying to put fire above it, and it just dries up.
Fail test as well. Yeah, this
you got cool. A test right here fails on increasing volume. Next bar's up on low volume. I mean, every way you slice it, it looks weak.
Yeah, I do agree with you. If you know, it looks weak and it looks like it wants to break that level, but it might take for the rest of the session to do it. I don't know.
Both coming off. There we go. Almost got filled on the first one. Came down to the tick, right?
Yeah, that's gold. Yeah, that's definitely going to come off. Okay, just bear with me.
So now we got to move our stop down. Just up thrust it on the 5 minute, up thrust, no demand. So even on the 5 minute, it looks weak, guys. I mean, you have this markup. Mark, not sure if you're in the room. we have this markup right into this previous swing high on the 5 minute. And now all of a sudden, the next bar, it's a low volume up thrust. So it's weak on the five, weak on the one. I don't see any anything strong yet. So, it's a matter of sitting and waiting. You guys getting good weather in the UK right now?
No, miserable, but, you know.
Do we go to money from last time?
Yeah, no, miserable, Abraham. Wet, windy, horrible. Right, starting to break through this level now, so now we might have a little runner here. Let's keep an eye on it.
So we pushed down and closed below this last markup on decent volume. We just need a continuation. We start getting continuation. We should challenge that 0621 level and break it down. Start trailing the stop and then some profits. It'd be nice to lock in a nice little chunk of change right before Thanksgiving. Celebrate the nice way.
Pay for the turkey, yeah.
Yeah. Wouldn't mind having some of that ham that we had in Barcelona.
Oh, I tell you what, that's the best. Yeah, no, well, when we first met with Abraham, we met him in Barcelona. I was speaking at the Traders Expo out there. And by the way, for those of you that don't know, I'm trading in a competition in London on the 11th of December at the London Traders Expo with my good friend Rob Hoffman. We're trading against each other, so that should be fun.
Is that going to be live on stage, or are you guys each going to be at your own computer terminal?
No, live on stage. They've got about 4,500 people registered, so it'll be quite big. Same as I did at New York, Abraham, same deal.
Hey, you got to love it. No pressure.
No, I don't care. I mean, I've done all right. In the ones I've done previously, and I've done fine, so, you know. And Rob is going to be using some of the VSA signals as well, so we'll both be trading the same sort of thing. So, no problem. I quite enjoy it, to be honest. Here we go. Okay, just bear with me a sec. I've got the kids just running.
I got my little girl home from school today. No school because of Thanksgiving. So I got a packed house as well.
Yeah, me too. Right. Yeah.
Not sure what his strategy has been.
Well, I've worked with Rob in the past. I mean, he uses volume, but he also uses momentum and stochastics and stuff. He uses quite a few different formulas, but he's a very good trader. I mean, I've traded with him probably 12 times now, I think, in the last 3 or 4 years. Yeah, he's good.
So you can see we're starting to see volume on that hard right edge here, starting to pick up.
Exactly what I'm seeing. Yeah.
Let's slice on through.
Yeah, well, if it takes out the buying climax bar, then it's a great trade. I'm still in the trade at the moment. I want it to get through that 1.0619 level. That would be ideal if it can get down through. Yeah, down through that level here. Right just below that bar on an increase in volume. That would be the ideal situation. Mom, I'm kind of confused. So the trouble is, with these Thanksgiving sessions, you do get very narrow spreads, and it moves sideways a lot, as you can see. So this might take an hour or two to get there.
Yes, and we just had a no supply. So it runs out of steam. It has to, right? Of course.
Yeah.
Starts rushing down, good volume, and then boop, drops off. But stops still at break even plus one, so not going to lose money on the trade. That's primarily number one. Number two is if we can trail some money, be great. Ben, again, not quite sure, man. You'd have to ask him or get some follow-up on that, but not familiar with his approach. Yeah, I don't want to take over your session.
No, listen, you're doing great. I mean, I can take the charts, but I'm going to wrap up in about 15 minutes anyway, because there's not a lot. I mean, I'm just trying to wait to see if this breaks lower. Let me take the screen back, guy, Abraham. And if they want to contact you about your room, can you put your details up?
Yeah, absolutely. I'll post the link.
Okay, so there's the trade. I'm just going to see if this breaks this in the next 15 minutes. If it does, we'll stay with it. If it doesn't, we will wish you a happy Thanksgiving, and we'll see you again all on Monday of next week for the opening bell. And Philip's got an event as well with me. Philip, I think Philip's going to come and join me as well, I believe. Okay. What time did you finish Friday? Just see if Philip's here. Just bear with me.
Oh, okay. That's not a call for...
No, not at the moment. Okay. Any questions at all, by the way? Well, we're just watching. We're going to stick on this for the moment because this is the live trading room. It's not so much about, you know, what Abraham and Darren are doing. You know, they were looking at a lot of multiple charts. This is where I've seen the trade today, and this is where I'm currently trading. So we'll watch it. Trying to break 1.0620. That's the key level to take out.
Just got filled on that first profit target for gold.
Okay, here we go. It's starting to attack it, which is what we're looking for.
Yeah, it's nice that both gold and euro are both starting to make some moves.
They heard us talking about Thanksgiving, that's why, you see. So they're giving us a trade finally. Yeah. No, it's been good. I mean, it's been okay today. Not ideal, but okay.
Well, at least I got Thanksgiving dinner paid for with the gold trade.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, now I know I was asked to look at the yen earlier, the Japanese yen, so I'll have a very quick look at it so we can have a quick idea as to where that's going. First thing we'll do is stick the scanner on. No, there's nothing here for me. At the moment, it's too choppy and it's too mixed here in the scanner, and it's why it's chopping up and down. So I personally, looking at that, would not be in a position at the moment. Let's have a look at the 15-minute chart. Yeah, it's rolling over on the 15. It is rolling over on the 15, but I don't see any reason. I mean, look, it's really a sideways movement at the moment. So that wouldn't be my preference to trade at the moment, the yen, which is why I haven't traded it, actually. Let's go back to this this euro trade here. This is more obvious. You go for the obvious trade is what I would say to people. Go for where the market's telling you it's got a trade. And today, this is where I saw it, which is why I've traded it. Now, I don't even think the pound was particularly obvious. Gold was fairly obvious. So go for the obvious trades, yeah? The euro looks pretty obvious from what I can see what they're doing. So, Maris, that's a pleasure. Matthias, that's a pleasure. No problem at all. Yeah, I didn't forget. I just wanted to, but, you know, I must admit, I didn't look. I think I looked at that chart yesterday and thought, nah, that's not something I'm going to trade. Okay, so we're going to just stick on this for the next 5-10 minutes. There we go. We're looking for this. Hold on a second. That's Tom. Hold on.
How are you guys doing today? You guys aren't anybody in any trades or looking to take anything, manage anything?
Yeah, hi, Abraham. That was just Tom confirming what we already saw in the euro. So he already knew I'd been short. He was just confirming it.
It's attacking that level now.
Yep.
Hopefully we can get that sliced down.
Yeah, that's the trigger number. The question is there any trades on the British pound? There might be, but it's not as obvious as the euro. The euro, to me, yeah, yes, it's setting up, but I wouldn't trade it yet. It looks like a secondary double top here. There's your hidden up thrust, and it looks like they're going to up thrust again. But I personally would not trade that yet. It's not as obvious as the euro. Go for where the money is. Go for where the money is. This is more obvious. But is it setting up? Rajiv, yes, it definitely is setting up. And I suspect that it will break down, possibly because it will be traded. The current Forex markets are open. So it could break down quite quickly. So definitely one to put on the watch list, Rajiv, I'd say. Adrian, I got your email, by the way, about the New York Stock Exchange, and they are definitely removing stop loss orders to remove the spoofing that's been going on, putting in fake orders. But Rajiv, you did identify, and let me just be clear for everybody, in case you didn't hear that, the New York Stock Exchange from the 26th of February, as in line with the NASDAQ, will no longer be allowing you to put stop loss orders or good to go orders, I think they're called, into the exchange. But there are ways around it. There are ways you can still protect your trade, but you will not be able to do it with a stop loss order on the floor on the exchange. And the reason is too many people were spoofing the market, putting in orders above and below it, looking like they were going to put a big order in at that price, and the market was being driven to that price, and then they withdrew the order and put in another order at the price. It's what's called spoofing, Adrian, and that's why they've done it. Now we've got a test here. This is critical now. okay, we've got a test back into this area right down here. Very, very good test there. Now, we don't have to do anything at the moment. We just wait to see the result of the test. But for those of you that are traders trading the New York Stock Exchange stocks, you probably need to be aware of that. And I will do I think I'll do a seminar on it next week as the type of strategies that we can use to protect ourselves in the event that we're in a position and you haven't got a stop loss order to protect you. But it's only in the stocks. It's only on New York Stock Exchange and NASDAQ stocks. It does not apply to Forex futures or any of the other markets. Exactly. You can use options very effectively. Absolutely, yes. That's right, Ben. Yep, you can put puts in. You can also hedge using options. So you can actually use it as a hedge. But we'll talk, because obviously we're running a hedge fund here. That's exactly what we look for, is hedging your trades. You can use it as a hedge. But yeah, options, I think, is the best way to trade stocks at the moment. If you don't want to buy common and hold on to it for a long time, then you use the options to trade the market if you're scalping it or if you're swing trading it. With options, it's a swing trade. You're looking at, there are different ways to trade options, but that's what most of the customers that I've had an email from are going to go to. They're going to start trading options again. Now we're attacking this level. So we're now at a good level here. VSA with options works well, Ben. Very well. And Adrian, that's a pleasure. No, I did get your email. I was going to email you back. I've just been really busy today. But yeah, now you're in the room. Yeah, I saw it. And it is confirmed. I can confirm that's true. I spoke to a broker on the floor who's confirmed that. So it is a correct story. It's not a rumor. Okay, now we're at my trigger number right now. So we're going to watch this, because again, I don't want to be greedy now. I've got some nice profit from the market today. We know that they test this level. I'm going to watch this like a hawk. Now, first of all, stop to break even. I'm not going to lose any money here. Again, I've locked in my profit. Now, I'm watching this very carefully. If it comes back down to 16, I'll try and take some more money out of the market. But I know this level is fairly critical now. And what I'm going to do is I'm looking, what's the low of that bar? Let's have a quick look. It's at 19. Okay, so it's gone down to 19. But they do this. They mark it down into that area and then straight back up. So we'll just watch it. I'm looking at the close of this bar. It's going to be very important. I'd like to see this close on the low on an increase in volume from the previous bars. That's what I want to see. But again, now I'm in a trade that's now broke even. I've already made my profit on the two trades that I've taken, one of which, of course, was in the trading room here. And now we're just watching the market to tell us what it wants to do. Okay, just Abraham, just take over 30 seconds here. I'm just going to go and shut the door and grab a glass of orange, because my daughter, you can hear her in the background doing her reading lessons. So if you want to have a quick look at your charts as well, that'd be good.
Still in the euro short, guys, trailing the stop. I moved it down a couple ticks to two ticks above this last markdown. So now the stop's at 0630. Locked in four ticks on it, currently up 14. Just had that up thrust come on the 1 minute. So it's still looking weak. We just have to close and have a break down below this area. You can see all of a sudden volume's drying up. Not good. Also moved the stop down to two ticks above this last swing high on gold. Stop is at 70.80, so locked in another six ticks on this short, and we took 11 ticks on the first one. So overall pretty decent, even though the markets are kind of flat. Yeah, Gregory, if you'd like to show, Gregory says he's in pound Swiss and pound yen trade. If you'd like to show, that'd be great.
Hi, guys. Hi, everybody. Abraham, can you hear me?
Can you hear you loud and clear? Just can't see your screen.
Didn't switch it yet. Gavin, hi. One more time today. Can you hear me? Okay, good. So you can see that I'm now in ups. Sorry, you cannot see. Can you see my screen, guys?
No, just the audio, no screen.
Can you see it now? I have shared the screen. Abraham?
Yes, sir. It's all, we can see your screen now.
Perfect. Can you actually make me an organizer, not a presenter, because I cannot see the questions. Well, anyways, let's do it like it is right now. So, you can see let me get rid of them at the moment. So there were two alerts today. Actually, there were more alerts. At the beginning of the day, we've got an alert on GBPCHF long, and the level of entry was exactly there. I think that has already been discussed in the trading room of Abraham and Darren in the morning. And there was huge volume at that moment of time, and I was thinking to close the trade, but then I have seen a second alert which was pointing exactly to that level. I was thinking at the beginning to wait and open the second lot for this long trade, but I decided not to do that because tomorrow is the Thanksgiving day, so there might be so the market back and forth. And because of that, well, I'm just still in that trade. What I'm waiting for, I'm waiting. The target should be this on this green line, if you can see that. This is a very, very serious level of resistance. I hope that they will mark it out till that level today. And if they will do that, then most probably next week we will expect that the price will be going down. So we will see. The second alert, what we've got, actually we also have several alerts on GBP, GBY. The first alert was to get long at that level. I've got long on that level. There were a few ticks profit, then the price dropped down. I was stopped out tick to tick. You can see that the spread here on my broker is quite high for these currency pairs. For GBP, GBY, I think this is 5 or 6 ticks. And for GBP, CHF, it's a 7 ticks. Alerts at the moment, the automatic alerts, what we are developing at the moment, they are not taking spread of the instrument into consideration. Or volatility, which is also important for forex, for futures trades. So, because I have kept the stop as it was told in alert on that approximately at that level, I've been stopped out. Then the second alert on GBY has come on that level. I have opened the position here. Now I'm in a profitable trade again. So both trades are in a break-even. Plus 1-2 ticks. For this, I'm expecting get back here. For GBP, GBY, I'm expecting the profit level target to be here. approximately here. So I suspect that they may come to that level. Let me move that a bit here. Due to the things given, I think they may come somewhere here for GBP, GBY. And based on the alert, the profit level is here at that level, at that point. But I'm expecting to get it somewhere here, so I'm not going to close the trade if we will reach that level. Again, quite difficult day to trade because of public holidays tomorrow and on Friday. But still, there are some trades. Here, I'm around 40 ticks profit. Here, around 20 ticks, approximately 15, 20 ticks, something like that. So this is where we are with that. Abraham?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if any questions, I'm ready to answer. If no questions, I can hand it over to you. Or to Gavin.
Nice.
If Gavin.
40-45 pip trade on the pound Swiss.
Yep.
And I'm Euros still breaking down. And we're confirming on the hour. I didn't notice, but on the hourly, we actually have a no demand on the prior bar. And we closing down here should be a confirmed no demand. So we may see activity picking up in the next 4 minutes.
Oh, yeah. It is really no demand on hourly. There is also supply coming in on 30 minutes with the next bar down in a very, very, very strong level of resistance, on a very strong level of resistance. So I suspect that it will run right now very fast down. Should be.
Like I said, maybe they're waiting for the hourly to close in the next 2.5 minutes, and then we may get an afternoon. Late afternoon push, but we are breaking down that ultra high level on the 5 minute and on the 1 minute. I think the last level is going to be 0616 on the hourly, and then we should be retesting the day session lows, hopefully by the close.
Yeah, Abraham, I've got a target now of 0615. I'll just take the screen from you, I'll show you, and then we'll wrap it. But I mean, yeah, it's been quite a good day. So
please, the screen is mine, Gavin. Hi, Gavin.
Hello, Abraham. Hello, Gregory. How are you?
I'm fine. I was presenting GBP, GBY and GBP CHF trades. I'm in both trades still, and they are running quite well.
Brilliant.
They are up my target levels.
Super. So I'm at break even on this euro trade, the euro here. So I've carried it down. Okay, we've come through the trigger number here. 615 here is going to be a retracement, and it's almost going to be a 50% Fibonacci retracement to this level, which it may find support at. But I'm pretty comfortable now with my profit that I've made. I'd like to make $400 on the day on this account. That would be a nice trade. I'm at break even at the moment. I'm just going to watch it, and because it's slowed down a little bit. It is coming down on low volume. There's not a lot of volume around at the moment. But I will say, for those of you that want to continue to trade into the afternoon session, you might find a little bit of movement coming in as they close the market, which will be around 9 p.m. tonight, UK time, 3 p.m. Chicago time. You might see some big volume coming in, to just be aware of that. At the moment, though, the trades today here in the trading room were very clear. There was a long trade, which I took earlier, right? And then there was a short trade, which we took in the room here. And you can see that actually the strategy that Tom has adopted, which is to be aggressive when you see a buying climax followed by no demand, and you can see what's happened. It's come all the way down. And now what we're looking for, if you want more confirmation of the weakness, any no demand bar here would confirm it. But I've got a funny feeling here it's going to maybe try to pop up a little bit. So what I'm going to do, as we close, I'm going to take some profit here. Whatever happens now, I'm in profit. Okay, so we've got another test. This is exactly what we'd expect to see. So whatever happens, I'm profitable now. I'm not at risk anymore of losing any money. That was the break even. I got that there very quickly, which is my trading strategy. Now I'm into profit. I've already had profit for the day. And whatever happens, I've just been filled. There you go, because they popped it up after the test. So that was a good decision, I think, because they're testing it. And they will pop this up occasionally. You may get a no demand bar. First of all, when you've finished your trading session, cancel all. Okay, make sure you flatten, make sure there's no orders in the market. And it's been a very good day today. And that was only in two hours and 20 minutes of trading. So not a long day of trading. Marin, I'm still working on that. In fact, I've got it here. The checklist that I've got is still being developed, and I can show you it if, well, you don't need to see it. When it's ready, I'll send it. When it's ready, I'll share it with you. Okay, we're still refining it. There's a few things we're working on that are really cutting developments, really breakthrough developments in what we've been doing. And one of them, again, is trade setups that are not necessarily trend related. They're related purely to the high volume followed by the low volume. That's what you've just seen me trade. That was irrelevant to trend. I wasn't using the scanner on that one. I was just looking at two simple principles. And Tom and I were trading this, and you know something? You can see they work. So those are the sort of things you want to look for. And it's, again, it's the very opposite of the bottom. It's very high volume on the down bar, followed by a test. That's really it. It's not really complicated, but they work. They work. Let me hand back over to Abraham. Abraham, anything you want to add about your trading room? Or next week, it's Monday, isn't it? If they want to contact you, have you put your details in?
Yeah, we posted the link in the room for anybody who has questions on the room, hours of operation, fees, or any questions. I also put my email in the room so you guys can contact me directly. We will not be open tomorrow for Thanksgiving or Friday, so we will be available beginning Monday. So you guys, if I don't talk to you beforehand, have a great weekend. Enjoy the turkey. Just take care.
Piotr says, are you doing an end session today, a market wrap today, or is that not necessary because of the Thanksgiving thing?
Yeah, no, this morning we stated we're not doing the afternoon recap. We'll begin the normal sessions again starting on Monday.
Yeah, perfect. Okay, great. Gregory, if you want to say a few final words and say goodbye.
I would like to wish those of you who are celebrating Thanksgiving happy Thanksgiving. Relax, because I suspect that next week will be full of trades. Welcome to the trading room and trading the market service. We are here to help you guys to start trading, and all what is under development right now is intended to help you with that.
Great. And I'd say exactly the same thing as Gregory just echoed there. Sorry, Gregory, I didn't mean to interrupt. Well, you didn't finish.
I did finish, Gavin.
Oh, good. Yeah, so from all of us, and we'll see you after Thanksgiving. So next Monday, we'll be kicking off again. Lots probably going to be going on. But for those of you in America that do celebrate Thanksgiving, we wish you a very good Thanksgiving session tomorrow. I'm going to have mine on Sunday, looking forward to it. And I say, I hope you enjoyed the session today. Originally, I was long, then short, and then down to the profit target here, where the trigger number is. We've seen some testing. Be aware, there may be quite a lot of Americans closing positions in the next hour and a half, ready for Thanksgiving. So you might get some big volume coming in. Just keep that in mind. And we'll see you all again on Monday of next week. Have a great holiday if you're in America, and all the best to the rest of you. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.